Welcome, biologists. In this session, we're going to take a look at how action potential is generated. In part one, we had a look at how resting potential was established and maintained. And this one, we're going to have a look at how action potential is generated whilst using a graph, which is very, very popular on the exam. So first of all, an action potential, this is the proper scientific terminology, really, for a nerve impulse. And an action potential is generated in a neuron as it travels along the neuron as the nerve impulse travels along. So the first thing that we need to know here is that resting potential here in minus 70 millivolts is at this point here on the graph, but also on the other side, which you'll see in a minute. Now, resting potential is established and maintained using the Sony potassium pump, which we looked at in the first video. Now, once I've got some kind of a stimulus in my nerve, which again we'll look at in the next couple of videos, if this stimulus causes the membrane's potential to go above the threshold value, an action potential will be generated. And the first thing that happens in an action potential is depolarization, which is where the graph slopes upwards like so. Now, in depolarization, the sodium volt gated channels are going to open in the membrane. And because I have a lot of sodium, a high concentration of it outside of the neuron, a lot of sodium is going to rush into the membrane along its electrochemical gradient. Now, because I have a high concentration, a lot of this sodium moving in, a lot of these positive ions moving in, it means that this movement of ions is going to increase the membrane potential. Now, this is an example of positive feedback, because when the sodium volt gate channels open, it will trigger others along the membrane to also open as well. At number three there at the top, at the peak of the graph, this is where the sodium volt gate channels are going to close and the next part of the action potential occurs. And this is called repolarization, where the graph slopes downwards. Now, at this point here at number three, I've got the sodium volt gate channels closing, but I've also got the potassium volt gate channels opening. And because I have a high concentration of potassium inside of the neuron, my potassium is going to rush out of the membrane along its electrochemical gradient, decreasing membrane potential because I have a lot of positive ions moving out of the membrane. The next stage of the graph is with the refractory period, which is this whole period here, and it includes hyperpolarization. Now, in the refractory period, what happens is these potassium volt gate channels close, but they take a little bit longer to close than we would like. So therefore, I've got a little too much potassium leaving the membrane, leaving the neuron. And this causes my membrane potential to drop below minus 70 millivolts. And it takes a little bit of time to establish the resting potential again. Now, don't forget this occurs through the sodium potassium pump, which we looked at in the previous video. But hyperpolarization is this overshoot of potassium, if you like, where I've got a little too much leaving my neuron. Now, this hyperpolarization is really important because it allows the impulse to travel in one direction along the neuron. As you can see here, I've got action potential occurring here at part number one, and this will trigger sodium volt gate channels to open in the next part of the neuron, which you can see here. Now, as a result of an action potential occurring in this part of the neuron in the previous picture, it takes time to recover. So as you can see here, this is undergoing repolarization and then the hyperpolarization in the refractory period. Now, because of this, I can't have an action potential occurring in this part of the neuron anymore, because an action potential can only occur where I have resting potential in that membrane. So therefore, an action potential can only travel in one direction along the membrane. So that's how an action potential is generated, including reference to positive feedback. In the next video, we'll take a look at myelination and the frequency of impulse transmission. Guys, good luck with your exams, and don't forget to use good scientific terminology in your answers. All the best.